So right now I'm staying in my quarantine hotel. I got back from a business trip. It's pretty weird in here. I don't know if you can see my hotel, but it's all dark and creepy, but I'm actually kind of enjoying it. But anyway, so what I'm talking to you guys today is the difference between a bass and a double bass. And right away, as you can see in this image, the basses and double basses are totally different. They're both performing the same function in the sense that they're doubling the octave of another instrument. And they're providing more warmth and more low-end tone and more low-end frequencies, but they're fundamentally quite different, Like this one is clearly a hollow body. It's got the F holes cut in it. It's much bigger. I believe the standard double bass is 6 feet, and this double bass right here, excuse me, the regular bass is much smaller. You wrap it it's wrapped up with the guitar strap, and you have it perpendicular to your body, whereas this will stand upright, as the name suggests, literally called upright. But yeah, another thing that's worth mentioning that is probably the most important is that double basses are also played with a bow in many cases, and compared to a bass guitar, which is not. A bass guitar, you either play it with your fingers or a pick. Granted, you could play a bass guitar with a bow if you wanted to, especially if you used flat wound strings. Which brings me to my next point, which is that if you want to use a bow on the bass, or excuse me, which brings me to my next point, which is that a double bass uses a bow and it uses flat wound strings. And that makes sense if you think about what a bow does. Like, it literally scrapes across the string. So you want a flat wound string for that. And the same thing could be said about violins as well. I literally had to just delete some storage on my Mac, which is pretty much par for the course these days. But anyway, another difference is that the shape is obviously much different. So clearly, like, look at these two basses right here. This is like a Fender looking bass, and then this is a double bass. This one is like a whale, it's kind of fat looking. It's got a big butt, whatever you want to call this. It looks like literally a butt, like a big butt on a woman's body, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's what it looks like. The next thing is that as I said before, they use different strings. A bass will use round wound strings usually, whereas a double bass will use flat wound, and that's because of the bow. Granted, you can use your fingers instead of a bow on the double bass. Yeah, they also double the octave of two different instruments. So a bass guitar, it will double the octave of a guitar, whereas a double bass will double the bass of a cello. So that's going an octave below a cello, I believe. I think that's how it works. And obviously they have much different tones too. Like, if you pay attention to what a double bass sounds like, or a cello, or an upright bass, whatever you want to call it, they sound quite a bit different from a bass guitar. They sound very cool. I really like them. I think they're super cool. I use them in beats and music all the time. Just like the pluckiness and like the there's like a certain kind of a low mid range, I would say, that comes from the double bass, or I don't know what frequency range. To me, it sounds like lower mids. It's kind of like a like this like plucky warmth, like cool sound. It's much different than a bass guitar. As I said before, yeah, the double bass uses a bow, whereas a bass guitar does not. And ultimately, I think a lot of people wonder, like, can you play one if you can play the other? And I think the answer to that is yes. However, there's going to be a learning curve. Like, if you're going from the guitar, the bass guitar, to the double bass, there's going to be a significant learning curve. Mostly in the use of the bow. Not only that, but the lack of frets. Thankfully, they are similar in the sense that the strings are tuned by fourths. So it's not that much different, but you're gonna have to get used to the fact that it stood upright. You're gonna have to get used to the fact that there's no frets. You're gonna have to get used to the fact that you're not holding it perpendicular to your body. You're gonna have to get used to the fact that it's much bigger, and it's just gonna be a different vibe. But you know what? I think I wouldn't be surprised if a solid bass player, a solid bass guitar player, was able to learn the upright bass in like 3 months. Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised. Now, would they get all this nuances and the subtleties of an expert double bass player? Probably not. But I think they would be able to get a good handle on it after about 3 months of legitimate practice, practice every day. But anyway, that's all for this video. Make sure you like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. All right, peace.